We have all heard the often repeated mantra, one person in 10 is homosexual. Though not quite as commonly used now as during the past couple of decades, this declaration has been stated so frequently and has been spread so widely that it has been irreparably ingrained into the brain of our collective consciousness. But is this ubiquitously dispensed information accurate? And even more rarely is the question asked, from what source is this widely circulated figure derived? To answer that last question, non-straight advocates and their supporters appeal to the seminal work of Dr. Alfred Kinsey. The famed Kinsey study, which was a landmark examination into the phenomenon of human sexuality, was originally conducted in the years 1948 and 1953, and was already highly controversial even for its own time. So how do the results of Kinsey's original research stack up today, nearly three quarters of a century later? Since the Kinsey reports were published, and due to the ever-increasing outspokenness of the so-called gay community, subsequent studies and surveys relating to non-straight sexual identity have been conducted and published. And what were the results of these later findings? Depending upon how the survey questions were asked and how the given answers were compiled, the actual figures regarding persons identified or identifying themselves as homosexual fell drastically from 10% to a lot closer to 3% of the population. But whenever those who were surveyed were asked if they identified themselves or their sexual activities as exclusively homosexual, those numbers dropped even more sharply, from around 3% down to around 1 and 1.5%. So rather than the Kinsey figure of 10 out of 100, the real numbers of those identified or identifying themselves as exclusively homosexual consistently shows up at around 2 or at the very most 3 out of every 200. Why such a serious and severe discrepancy? Well, as was already observed, much depends on the way a question is asked, what type of question is asked, and of whom such questions are asked. Were there some significant differences between the Kinsey method and the later surveys? All evidence indicates that such was indeed the case. First of all, let us look at Kinsey's sampling pool. According to the research, Kinsey drew his sample population from often very dubious sources. One of the most significant and most telling included prisoners, a significant number of whom had been incarcerated on criminal sex charges and other quote-unquote indecency charges already. Also overrepresented in his interviews were homosexuals and sex workers. It was also noted that Dr. Kinsey was less than careful in some of the questions he asked and how certain answers were recorded. But there's an even more embarrassing problem non-straight defenders face whenever they appeal to what they refer to as the Kinsey numbers, and that's this embarrassing and inconvenient little fact. Dr. Kinsey never said that one person in 10 was homosexual. So whenever non-straights, their advocates, and their defenders and supporters make reference to Alfred Kinsey regarding the 1 in 10 claim that many of them still adhere to or promote dishonestly, one would do well to ask him or herself if these persons upholding this claim might either have misinterpreted the study or are perhaps just ignorant of what was genuinely revealed and presented by the report, or if they are quite simply flat-out lying and or disregarding the factual material just so they can promote their non-straight agenda any way they can. Either way, it goes without saying that knowingly or unknowingly, they are entirely guilty of spreading gross misinformation. Tell me.